When we talk about the problems that seem so insurmountable until you get blue in the face or green or maroon, it's so easy to get frustrated. I mean, isn't that how you sometimes feel? We've had two revolutions that's been copied the world over, but are we doing any better? So once in a while, it's good to talk about not just the problems, but a vision of and aspirations for our country. Over the weekend, a conference called ReImagining Pilipinas Bukas was held in Antipolo. Close to 100 artists, politicians, government officials, civil society activists, soldiers, journalists, businessmen, educators from a variety of backgrounds and generations were in that conference. The title of the conference, of course, gives us all a hint of what they talked about. The Philippines we can imagine, the Philippines we can envision, the Philippines we can dream of, but a Philippines that we need to work and sacrifice for. Join us as we go behind the scenes of the battlefields of our imaginations. I'm your host, Pia Ontiveros. This is Weekly Politics. Joining us tonight are those who participated in the conference, participated and convened the conference. Senator Francis Kiko Pangilinan, convener of the conference. Hi, Senator Kiko. Thank you for being here, kahit na may sakit kayo.
Gumagaling na.
Gumagaling ka na, no? Pero you mean during the weekend, you were sick?
The whole weekend I had the flu. Weekend.
So hindi ka nakasama
sa picture taking. But I was in and out of the conference.
Ah, okay. Jim Paredes, of course, artist and a teacher at the Ateneo. Yeah. Hi, Jim.
Hi.
Thank you. For coming to the show, first time. Marion Pastor Roses, an independent curator, and Mark Ruiz, a social entrepreneur. Thank you for being here. So this represents a whole generation, ano?
A whole generation and multidisciplinary.
Yeah.
Multidisciplinary.
Multidisciplinary. Okay. Tell us first, Senator Kiko, how did you put the conference together? Where did this all start? It didn't start out as an idea for a conference, no? Parang nag-usap-usap
no, no. Lang. We were after the elections, and then we were concerned about, okay, how do we bring people power to the next level? Mm-hmm. You know? Because obviously the elections of May 2010 were unprecedented. No? Talagang lumabas ang tao, landslide ang pagkapanalo, and phenomenal, no? And therefore, we were concerned. After the elections, that's it. Mm-hmm. Where do we bring, you know, people who want to do something more than just vote for the president or vote for change? How do we bring it to the next level? Yeah. And so we came together, the conveners, and said, you know, it's not just about winning. In fact, I said this already before. You know, it was the people who made Pinoy win, the president win, and it'll be the people. Supportive of him and engaging him that will make him succeed.
Mm-hmm.
And so the challenge really is, okay, how do we bring people power after we all wanted change? We all wanted to see a new country. We all wanted to see a new direction for the nation. And then now we're confronted with a lot of challenges. So it doesn't end with elections.
So the operative word there is engage. No,
that's
I like
right.
the way you said that. To engage the government, the administration, President Aquino himself. Mm-hmm. In other words, not leave him to govern, not leave government to itself.
Yes. You know, it's like, you know, we're all soldiers, you know, during the campaign, and then we fought hard, and then after winning the war, you know, do we stop being soldiers and we go back to our farms, our homes, etc., or do we continue to soldier and consolidate the gains and the victory and then bring it to the next level?
Okay, so it started out like I was asking also kanina, no? He it's not like you planned a conference, you were just talking among kasama ka rin, Jim.
What happened was you know, we were together and, you know, I mean, what else can we do? It was, again, an open thing. Where do we bring it? Where do we bring all of this enthusiasm? And then I actually remembered that when Kevin Rudd in Australia came into power, he actually asked citizens to, you know, dream of what Australia could be within the next so many years and think of doables. Mm-hmm. So because that might be something that we can sort of look into. Mm-hmm. And then nagkasabay na, you know, it's been 25 years since EDSA, so why not 25 years? So, mm-hmm. naging ganun ang dynamic niya.
Aha, okay. So, parang talagang citizen involvement, yeah. No? Citizen and participation.
Yeah, and then, what do you call this? Fashion the Philippines to where you want it to go.
Yeah, oh. But what you're doing here is changing a mindset also.
Yes.
Because for the longest time, oh, that's government. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, mm-hmm. yeah, we're civil society, but we're not in government. We're not with government. Mm-hmm. So you have to change that also.
Oh, yeah. I mean, the whole idea here, as Kiko said, is engage, no? Mm-hmm. And, kasi, well, for me, personally, I thought that our experience with Cory was after we put her there, and then in spite of the coup d'etat, nobody was rallying. Mm-hmm. I thought there was something wrong there. Mm-hmm. So I said, hindi na pwede yung ganun na, you know, we put you there, bye, see ya. Mm-hmm. Di ba?
Yeah.
So, hindi na pwede. Kailangan talaga engage.
Yeah, okay. So, before a conference happens, syempre, parang meron kayong vision statement or something. No? What was the point? What's the point of the conference? No? Can you take us through that process? How did you, you know, come together and decide to talk about, you know, decide or talk about what is it that we're going to talk about in the conference? Ano yung mga objectives natin, ganon?
Well,
Marian?
We started talking to each other. That was all. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Remember, it was sort of like meeting people who were in the campaign. Some senators like Kiko and Sergio Osmeña and TG Gingona, but also people like Jim, May Paner, mm-hmm. people like Harvey Kerr, just a bunch of people. Mm-hmm. We're not barcada. Mm-hmm. But we thought that we had a few things in common. One of which is that, you know, we understood people power as having been that thing that ousted Marcos. Mm-hmm. And then people power again, that suddenly manifested itself in an electoral process. Mm-hmm. And then we realized
that skipped Ed Sendoza.
That's
okay,
true.
I mean,
that's true.
That's another episode.
Yes. Yeah. That's true. That's a slip, a very revealing slip, I think. Mm-hmm. But we figured it actually takes a lot of forms. Mm-hmm. One of the things that we began to think about is, do we really understand this phenomenon? Mm-hmm. Do we really get what it's all about? Mm-hmm. Then we hear all sorts of things, remember? People want to harness, the government wants to harness people power, wants to put it into some kind of continuing relationship. Some of us in the talk groups felt a little bit of a reaction against the word harness.
Mm-hmm. Why?
Well, you harness pack animals, right? you use it.
Yeah.
Okay. We were thinking, before you even begin to think about, all right, what are you going to do with people power next after you're in government already? Why don't we just seek to understand it first? Unawain natin muna kung ano ang umiiral dyan. From that, we thought, well, if we want to do things like that, maybe we should learn to trust each other a little bit more. Mm-hmm. So in one meeting where it was a lot of people, mm-hmm. we decided...
Mm-hmm. When was that? What month?
A whole day meeting.
Was it? In Discovery,
November. Mm-hmm.
Oh. We thought, well, why don't we try a project which would basically be trust building amongst us, amongst mm-hmm. the people who were in that group. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Because, like I said, we were coming from different directions. We were in different parts of the campaign. Mm-hmm. But all of us supported the person who eventually became Pinoy. Mm-hmm. But not all of us want to join government. Mm-hmm. We do want to keep this position where we are supporters but also critical human beings. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And that seems to be a